Hello everyone, this is HTSKSK here, back with some more Heart of the Swarm StarCraft 2 action, and I tried playing a couple ladder games, and I was just putt-putting around, and then I got proxy 2 racks, and then I had a guy rush me with his very first Warhound, and then I realized that maybe making the Mothership Core before any units is not a good idea, so I decided to cast the pros, because they know exactly what they're doing, at least a lot more than I sure do. Up at the top right side is going to be Roots Vibe. And down the bottom left side, it may look like Darth Caesar, but it is indeed QXC. Sometimes he does ladder under the name Darth Caesar. So this is going to be a pro level game, and what I mean by that is it is two pros duking it out on the relatively small ladder. Only a couple hundred people play at a time on the ladder. I'm sure it's going to be more and more invites going out. And make sure, guys, that if you are in any way opted in for the Friends and Family Beta, that you check your email a lot, because they do send them out in waves, because they have to test the servers, they have to make sure that the game's not completely broken, and there were some early bugs in the first day, so, you know, if they're going to be sending out more invites, I imagine it would be pretty soon. So it is going to be another Terran versus Zerg, which I do know is something that I've already cast a lot on my channel. But this is what the pros are sending me. If you have a pro that you like, please tell them to send me replays. They can tweet at me if they want to send me stuff, or they can send them to huskyteers@gmail.com. That's HuskyTeers. So basically look up the word musketeer and replace the M with an H. And it's huskyteers@gmail.com. Or you can have them tweet at me if you would like. But so far I have replays from Sheth. Obviously, I have replays from QXC as well. I'm going to be following up with replays from White Raw, TLO, and a lot of others. So there'll be other races mixed in, don't worry. And also other matchups as well. I'm kind of curious to see how TBT plays out these days, because I have absolutely no idea. But it does look like QXC is going to be going for an expand first build here. Root Vibe, well, he's going to be doing the same thing, so we can actually just sit back here for a moment. And, oh, Darth Caesar, I 2 rack someone on ladder. That's hilarious, because that's actually what I was just talking about. Someone proxy 2 racks me, and I said GG, and I left the game, because I'm not here to practice my micro versus a 2 racks. I want to know actually how to use the new units, because good to know 1111 still works. That is true. That is very, very true, because if you spend 2 seconds reading a tooltip, then you are already behind. And I've been trying to think about it, and really, if you think about it, all the units that Protoss got are pretty high-tech. I mean, one of them you have to get from the Stargate, and it doesn't do any damage. It just allows you to harass their mineral line. One of them is from, I mean, it's the Mothership Core, which just kind of floats around your main base. And then the other one is the Tempest. So there's no low-tier attacking unit for the Protoss. For Terran, they did get the Widow Mine as well as the Hellhound. It's got to take me a while to learn all these names. The Hellhound, they got that as well. Is it the Hellhound? Oh, God, that's probably even wrong. But anyways, they got that. And are able to, you know, move out a lot sooner with that kind of stuff. Zerg, they ended up getting the Flying Caster, which is really high tier, and something that goes from the Infestation bit. So, the early game actually didn't change all that much. I mean, yes, there may be some Reaper, there may be some, well, that's really kind of it. I guess the Protoss could try and move out once their Mothership Core is out. So, I feel like the early game really hasn't changed all that much. There's no unit that's like, oh god, you can get the Zergling or you can get this unit. And I wouldn't expect Blizzard to ever add anything like that, because I think they're pretty content with the early game not being super confusing, you know, being kind of straightforward. You have Zealots, maybe Stalkers, you have Marines, maybe Marauders, you have Zerglings, maybe Roaches. And mixing in too much more of that, I think, would just be too confusing for people. SCV, get out of there. What are you doing? It is the Warhound, not the Hellhound. I keep saying Hellhound because of the Hellion. But they wouldn't name something super similar like that. So it's the Warhound, which we do have one right now on the way for QXC. Actually, there's going to be a Rotorn on the way. We did see Sheth use Roaches versus the Hellhounds to great effect, as the Hellhounds are very... Not Hellhounds. Warhounds. My God, if I ever call them Hellhounds again, then we can all just make fun of me. But anyways, the Warhound, it's a very interesting unit, because it just kind of does upfront damage. There's no damage modifier. It's not good versus armored. It's not good versus anything else. It just does quite a bit of substantial damage right out of the gate. It's a very fast unit, 220 HP. Of course, it has this ability that shoots missiles at armored units, but 23 damage. I guess I thought it was 22, but I guess it's 23. With a range of 7, so you can kind of just mass these up and micro them as best you possibly can. But here comes The Warhound Rush that we saw before, although this one is slightly delayed because it was an expand first build. But you do have to be careful because they can easily get surrounded by Zerglings from what I've seen. However, they are relatively fast, so should be able to escape if there's no Zergling speed. And look at this. This guy goes straight for the Queen Harass. And this is actually something that I feel like there's actually no way to prevent this from happening because there's no Roaches, there's no Zerglings. Your drones aren't going to be doing that much. But once the first couple of Roaches are out, it should be A-okay to hold this off. Another one is going to be on the way here. So QXC going to continue harassing with them. Warhounds able to deal with a couple of the Roaches relatively easily. You could also bring SCVs, I feel like, to get that mass repair action going on. Got to be going down here with yet another Warhound. So double Warhound, double the fun. Is there another Warhound? Yes, there is. Warhound number 3 will be on the way here pretty shortly. Got to try and do some damage to the hatchery. And actually, it will burn down that hatchery relatively quickly, as they do a lot more damage than just a single Marauder would. And they are going to attempt to take out these Roaches. Can the Roaches manage to catch back up? It's going to come down to the micro here. But if done perfectly, the Warhound should never be hit, although they do have an animation, an attack animation. So QXC has got to be careful here with that one. He is at 25 HP remaining. And surprised to see him actually be so aggressive with this one. And it's probably going to get taken out here if he's not too careful, which QXC currently is being careful. So very, very good harassment coming here out of QXC. 475 resources lost as Root Vibe trying to figure out, well, how exactly do I deal with this? Do I get earlier Zergling speed? Do I go for more Roaches? They're trying to engage on the creep. Down goes a second queen as well. 625 resources lost. Now, the question is this overpowered, or do Zerg players have to adapt their build a little bit differently? Because right now, I mean, you see Zerg players skipping Zergling speed. You see Zerg players going for an early third base. He does get a nice round here. Down goes one. The melee punches have begun, using their shield to do some of the damage there, and backed into a corner. These finally do get cleaned up, and that basically almost makes it even here. I mean, killing the queens does delay your production of workers and army by quite a bit, but QXC managing to secure a third base. But can he hang on to the third base? That's going to be the real question. We have seen all Terran players trying to figure out how to spend this money effectively. QXC doing a pretty good job so far, although he was hovering quite a bit of resources there. He does have the Hellions going to be moving on out. Most likely not going to upgrade these to the Battle Hellions just yet. And it's not even really an upgrade. I shouldn't call it an upgrade. It's a swapping out the stats. So you give up speed and mobility and the lining them up mechanic for more of a cone attack and more HP. So it's not really upgrading them, because it's free and they can do it right when they spawn. Now we do see two more of the Warhounds on the way. The Warhound picture is kind of weird in the production tab. It's kind of at a weird angle. But regardless, he is going to continue forward with this. Does he go for more upgrades? Yes, he does have the 1-1. What do we have coming out of Root Vibe, though? He has 1-1 of his own, making a lot of drones here. He is at 67, losing, of course, a couple there to those initial Warhound harassments. The queens now chill out. These queens are definitely smaller, or the creep tumors are just massive. But the queen's going to be chilling out here. This does make them easier to micro since they are smaller. Lots of hatcheries for Root Vibe as well. Didn't realize he had the macro hatch now completed, as he does have 4 hatcheries done with a 5th one on the way. So his army size is going to be pretty, pretty large here. We could be seeing actually a pretty long-term game, because, I mean, the Hellions aren't going to really be able to do that much as long as the Roaches stay in a good position. Even the Zerglings can buy enough time here. But it does look like right now, QXC saying, Husky, this is StarCraft. You can't predict how long a game's going to be. He's going to move out here with the Hellion and Warhounds to try and march on in. There are a lot of queens here. Quite a few Roaches, though. He could get a decent surround, but he's got to watch out for the Blue Flame Hellions now, as they will do that additional 5 damage to light units. You can see 19 total damage will be dealt, and the Zergis do manage to get us around on the right side, but Hellion's pretty good, able to clean up a lot of those, and QXC just going to be microing back and forth. 1100 to 1250 resources lost. The Queens just seem to be the weakest unit versus those Warhounds, as they can focus them down super easily with that range of 7. Queens only having that range of 5. Although they do have a range of 7 versus air, but that doesn't matter right now, as QXC continuing to harass here. Now, imagine a Terran right here harassing with the Warhounds and counterattacking with the Hellions at the third base right here. That'd prevent any units from being able to micro over there. Root Vibe is kind of forced to just focus on this engagement. He's got a lot of minerals. He's got to be working on getting fungal. And remember, if he throws out a fungal on these Warhounds, while they are large units, you can still grab a lot of units with that fungal. And the Roaches got to be a good counter to all those units that we see right now, because it's just Hellion Warhound here. So QXC has to rely on the micro of these units, as opposed to just engaging in a straight-on battle like you might with Marines and Marauders. You can't do such a thing with the Warhounds. We've seen them go down super, super quickly. They do have the plus one armor, though, as the 1-1 gonna be fishing. What happened? I guess it was 1-1 melee attack here. More units streaming over here for QXC. He is behind in supply. There's the Fungal number one. Can he do the damage he needs to? Roaches need to begin engaging here. We also need to see the Roach speed upgrade. Queen's gonna be brought off the line here to engage. They are no longer designated creepers. They are designated healers, transfusers. And it does look like the Roach attack here from Vibe is going to even this up by quite a bit. Going to even be able to chase this out with some Zerglings and deal with those Battle Hellions relatively easily. Down they go. Does look like Vibe has held on for now, has evened the score by quite a bit. Man, these games are so much better when I'm not playing them. Let's just say that. As we do have Siege Tanks on the way. Four Siege Tanks at a time. Siege mode, plus two, plus two. What is this? Evolve Burrow Charge. Is he seriously going for Ultras already? Oh, what happened over here? Looks like it's just going to be some buildings. I guess he does have the Hive Tech, so Burrow Charge is on the way. Oh, this just got a lot of fun. His Vibe has been saying, Husky, I'm saving up a lot of my money. I was able to hold off with the units I got. Now I'm going to go ahead and start making Ultras. Four on the way, and that means that the Burrow Charge is going to be devastating versus just the Hellion Siege Tank composition. Although if the Siege Tanks are set up quite well, the Charge isn't going to be helping them out that much. But we will see, because I don't actually know that much about this game, because it could actually be absolutely devastating versus the Siege Tank line. We are about to find out. The Zerglings will be forced to evacuate. Did allow the command center to survive there just because, you know, well, liftoff is pretty good. But right now, Vibe is up to four bases. QXC, though, is going up to five. He's got a command center over here on the bottom center as well. The Zerglings need to do some damage here, need to force the liftoff, at least need to kill off some of these workers. I think that's exactly what's going to happen here, as the Lings are running rampant in that mineral line. QXC is finally able to hold it off. He is almost done with 2-2, though, and he is going to be going up against Adrenal Glands, Ultralisks with Burrow Charge, and this just got a lot more exciting. Is Vibe going to be counterattacking down the bottom center as well? Will force the liftoff on this one, so QXC, while he is up to five bases, is really only mining off of three. Going to eventually get the other one established, but once that plus two attack finishes, these Zerglings are going to be almost worthless versus those Hellions. Lots of creep tumors on the way as this creep spread. Vibe saying, well, you know, I didn't quite do the best creep spread in the early stages, so let's just go ahead and make up for that right now here in the late stages. And he's got a lot of Ultralisks now. Going to be popping out. How many does he have? He's up to eight Ultras. My God. Does he have the Chitinous Plating just yet? That is still an upgrade, right? That's not something I got removed. Yep, Chitinous Plating right here. Definitely needs to begin researching that, because he's going to be relying on a lot of Ultras here versus Mech. And now that the Thors are now out, Thor is here. That means QXC can deal with those Ultras quite easily. Could even go for the 250mm strike cannons if he decided to, because that's going to be pretty good versus the amount of Ultras that he's going to be facing. Chitinous Plating is on the way. We do have 2-2 now done. Right there is the scan. QXC, does he decide to go for it? Or is he going to camp out right here? There is a couple of Infestors here. Could Fungal on these units? No, throws out the Infested Terrans, which look completely differently now, by the way. And here he goes. Got to be charging up there with these Ultras, using that ability to knock these units back. And oh my God, he is going to clean this out with relative ease. Holy Toledo. No, not Rock and Roll Racing, but able to clean that out. All of a sudden, what does QXC do? Mech not looking to be so good. Does have the three Siege Tanks up here, but guess what? That's a lot of Ultras. They can be charging down at these units. Hellions in position to try and prevent that from happening, but there goes the Infested Terran, still kind of weirded out by what that looks like, using charge on the Siege Tanks right now to clean those ones up, preventing them from doing any damage whatsoever. So now the tides have turned. What looked like was overpowered for Terran now may look super overpowered for Zerg. But at the same time, QXC's got a lot of supply, so I should never throw out the term overpowered. I'm just laughing at what the comments will probably be. But a good utilization of new abilities, new units here by both these players, using charge to clean up that mech line. But at the same time, QXC has started the 3-3. He's going to continue with the mech attack, intercepting a lot of drones here as well. Overall, workers killed 7-5. Super low, but he is going to go ahead and deal with these creep tumors. Could be a fungal growth right there if he's not careful. And he does get it down. That's going to be a lot of Hellions if he does indeed end up losing these, which it looks like he very well may, as Vibe just going to defeat this with his, it looks like his Infestors, although not enough, as the Hellions slip inside this expansion. Got to be killing off a lot of these drones. You got to remember that Vibe is way behind on supply right now, so he cannot afford to be losing these expansions. And the Ultra cleans all those up. He says, I don't see what the big deal is, guys. Clean up on expansion number five. Five kills on that Ultra. Chitinous Plating is done. The plus, what is it, plus six total? Is that how much armor Ultralisks have once that last upgrade is done? Yep. So if he is able to get out that last upgrade, he's going to have six armor Ultralisks. Still has to watch out. Ooh, almost managing to actually take this out here. It got dangerously low, dropping a lot of mules here as well, so that would have been a huge, huge waste. Thankfully for him, he was able to hang on. 190 supply to 157 here. I have a feeling we're going to be seeing a lot of mech plays out of Terran players moving forward, at least in the HotS beta, but simple fungal. No, the charge is back and forth to prevent these Hellions from getting away. Could charge there again if he decides to. And the charge ability, it has a, what is it, like a 20-second cooldown? What exactly is it? If I can find someone who hasn't used it just yet. But it is about a 20-second cooldown. You have to individually do a 30-second cooldown, excuse me. The expansion up here is locked down by some Hellions. And right now, QXC, I mean, he went from almost no workers killed to upwards of 30 here. And that does mean that he's going to be able to get back on track. And his macro slipping a little bit. You can see how much energy he had saved up on these mules. 4,000 minerals per minute. I was going to say he's going to be maxed out, but he's getting so much money that he already is maxed out. And that means that Vibe has got to get some sort of income going again. He's only got 77 drones as opposed to about the same for Terran, which is not a good spot to be in a Zerg unless you have a maxed out army, which, I mean, he almost does, but I don't know if he's going to have enough to kind of hang on here. We do have the armor plating there, four buildings, adding plus two armor. Now five armor on the planetaries, six armor on the ultras, and just lots of armor going every which way for all of these players. And I'm surprised to see Vibe continue going for Ultralis. I think the reason, I mean, he's doing this is just to try out the new Ultralis charge. But look at how many units he's losing because of it, as the Ultras are able to clean this up. But I'm almost afraid to look at how many workers have killed now. 55. He's just going to have to remake every single drone that he can. He is up to 11. But, I mean, what you see is what you get for Vibe right now, whereas QXC, he's got a little more options as he can begin making more command centers, more factories, and all around just more unit choices because he's going to be able to get the Widow Mines. He can get the Thor, Siege Tank, Warhound, and Hellion all from that building, whereas Zerg is just basically kind of stuck on doing the Ultralis tech right now as he doesn't have any sort of fallback plan. Killing this expansion right here would be nice, but he has to kill this expansion right here, which is exactly where QXC is. He has so much upfront damage that it's actually absurd. We are going to find out if ultras are good in these situations. That's a lot of fungals. That army cannot retreat, but no, no, no. That is not going to happen. Notice how the burrow is not an immediate charge. It actually is going to reveal. Oh, he says LOL there as, yep, you can't charge under tanks. So he's learning that, as so are we when they are sieged. So he just learned a tough lesson there, as it apparently gives error sounds. Now the Hellions got to be harassing these drones. QXC says, yeah, yeah, yada, 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 excuses. Now it's time for me to kill your drones. And I don't really think there's a whole lot that Root Vibe can do at this point. I mean, it's 191 supply to only 100. He does have 14 infestors on the way. We do see Seeker Missile on the way here for QXC. The harassment so far has been pretty top-notch. And he's even got to kill these infestors that just popped. How are they both stuck? Why is this infestor stuck? I don't understand that. That seems like a bug. But either way, I was able to deal with those infestors, and maybe he was even doing hold position to intentionally make them get stuck. But still seven infestors on the way, but losing those initial two, not going to be good. He actually has no army right now, so as soon as his army slowly death marches its way out here, I don't think there's a lot that Root Vibe can do. I mean, QXC, facts are facts. He's got 5,000 minerals, 1,600 gas. Now, there are going to be a lot of fungal growths here, potential for infested Terrans as well, but infested Terrans not very good versus the army that we're seeing right here. The hatchery gets taken out by these Hellions down here. And here comes the Widow Mines. Got to be marching these in to seal the deal. I feel like there's, I mean, I don't see how QXC could throw this one away. I mean, he's got Widow Mines. I don't think they do any extra damage because of the upgrades, but they do have three armor. How annoying is that to deal with? Zerglings have to be cleaning up some of this stuff. They could try and go for the Thors as well. Might be able to kill off that weakened one, but other than that, I mean, QXC is putting on the Vulcan neck death grab thingy, also the thing that Darth Vader uses, although Death Vader is probably his big nickname. As the infestors are now out, though, does he decide to throw out lots of infested Terrans? Yes, he does. He's gonna try and make this happen. We'll see if it works. Out they come, and the lost splash damage on the infestors themselves, but it does look like the might actually be able to clean this up. We'll even up the score a little bit, but I mean, at the same time, it doesn't even matter because he's got a lot of money. Although losing all these Thors has made his supply plummet by quite a bit. It's just that, where's that army back at home? Well, there it is right there. He's mixing in a lot of Ravens. Seven Thors at a time? What? QXC, you be crazy, girl. Seven Thors at a time. You thought Terran players couldn't get remaxed out quickly, but this is how you do it as QXC. I really don't think there's a lot that still that Vibe can do. I'm just going to go ahead and speed this up a little bit, as we did see great use of these units in the early game. He said, all my lings. Oh, God, where'd they die? I don't even know where they died. I feel. Oh, the mines. He died to the mines. They don't stick to your army anymore. But the mines. I'm just gonna back it up a little bit. Who cares? Who cares? I think we already know who's gonna end up winning this. But here's the Hellions harassing. They do eventually kill out this hatchery. Apparently they're attacking so fast that you can't even see their flames. Oh my god, they did actually individually kill that hatchery. So down it goes. The Widow Mines eventually come up here. There they are. And then we can kind of watch these guys for a moment. But, there we go. They're going to go ahead and burrow right there. The Hellion's going to be moving up to try to attack, trying to absorb some of this damage. Wow, he's just going to plant them right in this expansion. I'm kind of sad I missed this initially. Now, it looks like, look at that, the Hellions right there. Not as good at killing drones, but still not doing that bad as they do more of a cone damage. Which, while they do move slowly, if they get in the mineral line, they will kill almost everything. Boom! I love how they kind of slide across the ground. I'm not sure if that's intentional or not, but it looks sweet. And God, this is even more workers being slaughtered. 104 workers killed off. But it does look like he is going to clean up on that left side. Are there more Widow Mines? We got to keep an eye on these Zerglings. This is the important thing, is where do the Zerglings go before they die? It looks like it is going to be to the right side. Oh, Zerglings, don't do it. Don't do it, Zerglings. The Widow Mines are so good versus you. And here we go. Zap, zap, zap. He was hoping to grab those. Ouch. Ouch, ouch, ouch. He was hoping to grab those by, being able to do one on the Zergling and then running the Zergling away. And there he is talking about how his Zerglings died. QXC definitely looks to be in the lead in this game as it is 67 supply to 184. I mean, at this point, there's really nothing he can do, which I've said like 20 times. But we did see QXC using Widow Mines, using the Warhound, using the aggressive expanding, and using 7 Thors at a time. So, or 7 producing 7 Thors at a time. But right now, he has 13 Thors and 12 Widow Mines. There they are, just chilling right there. I don't know how many he was making at a time, but it is quite a few. More Command Snares are on the way. Basically, he's just practicing his macro at this point because he knows he's already got this. Do we have Neural Parasite? Yes, we do, but no energy. My Infestors got this. All right, Bro Infestors, Bro Festers, let's see it. Let's see it, but oh, nice Fungal right there. He's got a Seeker Missile the Ravens there. Very nice. Very nice. Unfortunately, he's still down by about 140 supplies, so that's gonna be a tough call for him. Or a tough uphill battle, but the Brofesters, can they do it? Seeker missling his own Ravens. Quite the nice play there. There's the scan going down, just cleaning out creep tumors. You know you're ahead when you're cleaning out creep tumors with Thors. And there's the Neural Parasite. Unfortunately, the Thors are not all attacking each other, which is proving to be problematic for Root Vibe, but he definitely did give a valiant effort, but I feel like that is going to be the end of the game. As, I mean, at this point, there's nothing you can do about 3-3 upgraded Thors. There's the GG. We all learned a little bit about Ultralisk Charge. Don't be charging into pure mech armies with Thors and Siege Tanks because you're going to be taking a lot of damage. Really, if that look one-sided, the main problem is that with no Broodlords out to deal with the mech, that Ultralisk, I mean, they're just not good versus mech. So let's kind of look at it on paper. Not that you're going to be writing this on paper, but the Warhound itself does a lot of damage. It attacks relatively slowly, but it does a lot of upfront single-target damage. Same thing with Siege Tank. It does a lot of damage versus armored units. Thors do a lot of upfront damage. So what that means is if the Zerg player is going for Ultras, that all that damage is focused perfectly, and it's kind of the perfect storm for Terran, to be quite honest, is that they're going to be doing just a typhoon of damage. But it was an awesome early game, at least, and we got to see that Ultralisk Charge in action. So hope you guys enjoyed.